Yo mga sir, kamusta? Taong 2007 nang maganap ang laban sa pagitan ni Jerry Peñalosa at Johnny Gonzales. Pero bago yan, sa laban po na ito ay 7 kababayan natin ang lumaban at ang 6 ay nasungkit ang panalo. Ngunit bigo po tayong may panalo ang main event. Kung naalala nyo po mga sir, si Ray Boom Boom Bautista, siya po ang main event. Ang kilabot at batang prospect ay hinarap agad sa warrior na si Ponce de Leon at natalo via first round TKO. Na isa din po sa tumalo sa ating topic ngayon mga sir. Ang Meksikano ay may record na 35 wins, 5 talo at 29 dito ay tinapos via knockout. Habang ang ating kababayan naman na si Jerry Peñalosa, dala-dala ang record na 51 wins, 6 na talo, 32 dito ay tinapos via knockout. Well, balik na po tayo sa topic. Ang batang Meksikano ay tiwalang-tiwala na tatalunin ng 36 years old na si Jerry Peñalosa. Sa matchup nga po na ito, ay luging-lugi talaga si Jerry Peñalosa dahil ang kanyang kalaban ay nasa prime. At nung panahong yun po ay 11 years ang gap ng dalawa, lalo na po sa reach, malaki ang agwat ng kalaban. Pero baliwala nga po ito sa ating kababayan dahil kung mananalo siya sa laban at mapapatumba ang kalaban, may gantimpala po itong matatanggap kay Sir Manny.
Because he really realizes that he's at a disadvantage on size and reach. So cutting off the ring is very important for him, and stepping over to his left is even more important to him, because that's the way Johnny's going. He's going towards his left.
What about the footwork, Lennox? Southpaw against the orthodox fighter.
Well, the southpaw is doing the right thing. If you notice, there's a couple.
Kahit po napakalaki ng kalaban at mahaba ang mga galamay, ay hindi po nagpasindak ang isa pa nating legend sa ating bansa na si Jerry Peñalosa. Kung mapapansin nyo mga sir, ang galaw at pamamaraan ni Jerry Peñalosa ay kagayang-kagaya ng ating pambansang Kamao dahil sila po ay magkaibigan. Natural lang na magkatulad sila ng estilo dahil kaliwete din po si Jerry Peñalosa at isa pa sila ay magkumpare.
Pero kung sa speed nga po natin titingnan, ay malaki po ang kabilisan ni Sir Manny kay Jerry Peñalosa.
What should he do more of, Lennox?
Well, he's doing the right things in the sense of he needs to throw more punches. He needs to be a lot stronger with his punches, especially with his jab. However, he's doing the right thing. He's putting the pressure on him. He's making him back up. He wants to get him against the ropes so he can take advantage of his shorter arms, out of the two.
It seems as if Peñalosa is slowly, small increments, figuring out a way to close the gap a little bit.
Well, he has to. He's the shorter boxer. He doesn't want to keep this fight at long range because he's at a disadvantage having shorter.
Check out.
Looking at Johnny Gonzalez's punches, there's not too much steam behind him. He's just using his arms to really throw the punches.
You know, when we talked with Peñalosa in the fighter meeting, he was convinced that this fight wouldn't even go the distance.
Well, he's on a search and destroy mission. He said, you know, I asked him what he's going to do in this round, in this fight. He said he's just going to search and destroy. He's going to not even really saying that, but, you know, we want to see him do it. And right now, he needs to pick up the pace a little bit, put a little bit more pressure on Johnny, and try and put him up against the ropes.
Low blow right on the belt line by Gonzalez.
And Gonzalez threw a good body punch there and a good hook to end the round. A little bit. Until he hears that last 10 seconds, then he picks up the pace.
He'll also block most of that from Gonzalez.
There's not a lot of body punches thrown right now, and the person that should be throwing the body punches is Peñalosa. He should be going to Johnny's body and trying to score some points and trying to affect him for the later rounds.
How does he get in there to get those body shots delivered when he's giving away the height and reach?
Well, that's where footwork comes in. He has to move in quick, and when he's ducking, he has to duck in.
Penalosa shoots a left hand to the midsection. Works a jab. Does Gonzalez need to be a bit busier?
Okun, Gonzalez is doing the right thing right now. He's keeping the fight in the center.
A hook working for Gonzalez. Penalosa steps in the pocket. End of three.
It's an easy fight for him because he's standing right there in front of him. Johnny Gonzalez knows he's going to come, and all he does is step back, throw a couple punches. They don't need to be hard, but, you know, Penalosa's there, and it makes it look like he's scoring the points.
So you're saying it's easy for Gonzalez right now?
Yeah.
To have a busier pace throughout, doesn't he?
Well, he needs to start it off right now. I mean, there's no use waiting to you hear that 10-second call on the mat and then try and win the round. You should try and win the round straight as soon as you hear the bell go. Impose your will against the guy, put him up against the ropes and win. The point of combination, Penalosa reacting after.
Gonzalez rips the right hand. Penalosa shoots a left hand to the body of Gonzalez. Got a one-punch title against Ray Batista. No knockdown so far in the fight. Gonzalez has been able to control the distance as Penalosa does get inside. But right away, Gonzalez fires back with the right hand. Penalosa, a highly respected boxer in the Philippines. In fact, he is the idol of Manny Pacquiao. Been a great champion at the tail end of his career here at the age of 35. Left hand by Penalosa. Gonzalez with a left of his own.
And Penalosa got through with a good left hand right there, right when Johnny Gonzalez was showing the left hook.
And for a guy that had to come down from 130 pounds to make the 118-pound level. Hello. Gonzalez seems to be pretty relaxed, and it doesn't seem like the weight loss affected him much.
Not too much. I mean, Penalosa doesn't really give him too much pressure to worry about, so he's relaxed. He doesn't feel the pressure anytime at all. He can do what he wants to. Anytime he wants to rest, all he does is get on his feet and move around.
That took to the side, Penalosa off balance. So each round is almost a carbon copy. Gonzalez will box, control the range, use the left hook, and then the last 15 seconds, Penalosa tries to open up.
And I'm sure as the rounds go on, Penalosa's going to become more desperate. I'm sure his corner's going to tell him, listen, you need to pick up.
Si Jerry Peñalosa nga po ay isa sa pinakamagaling sa depensa sa ating bansa. At yan din ang payag ni Freddy Rhodes. Sadyang ang mga Peñalosa brothers ay birador ng mga bodega hanggang sa ngayon. At sa round 7, tinamaan ang kaliwang Meksikano sa bodega at hindi na nakatayo pa. Kung tamaan ka nga po ng napakalakas na suntok katulad nito, ay talagang parang matatay ka po sa sobrang sakit.
Make this is a rough shot. He's not even breathing. He cannot make it, and this is where the weight has an issue and caused him to really take all that weight, the weight that he needed around his ribs to protect him. He had no weight there. And here we go, left to the body. Oh, right in the little shot there. Always finds it very difficult to come if he would have got up from that shot. And here we see it from another angle.
At naagaw nga po ng ating kababayan ang titulo at itinanghal na world champion. Yo, hanggang dito na lang muna mga sir. Millionaire Sports nga po pala. At muli, salamat.
By way of knockout and new WBO Bantamweight Champion.